Hi guys, welcome to The Bite. My name's Jackie, and today we're gonna be making a super simple weeknight dinner, a citrus seared salmon. This is really great for springtime. It's a great main dish that you can do with a side salad, a little bit of pasta or rice on the side, and you have yourself the perfect meal. Very few ingredients, as you can tell, but that's what makes this so quick and easy. So let me get into the ingredients so we can get started.
I have about a pound and a half of salmon here. I've had my seafood guy cut off the skin, but you can leave that on if you want to. Some ground ginger, half of a Caracara orange or any kind of orange you have on hand, salt and pepper, and that's literally it. We will need to be using an oven-safe skillet because we're gonna be searing the top parts, flipping it, and then sticking it into the oven to let it bake the rest of the way. And we'll also need some olive oil for the pan. I also have my oven preheating to 375, but we'll get to all that in a second. So what I like to start by doing is juicing a little bit of this orange right onto the salmon. And this is not something you want to do to let sit overnight. Citrus can kind of cook the salmon, and you don't want it to be partially cooked or cooked by the time you actually want to cook it. So I like to add a generous amount of pepper, some salt. I would rather always under salt than over salt, but to your liking. And then some ground ginger. I love the taste of ginger. If you wanted, you can also grate or use a garlic press to put some fresh ginger on. But I think the ginger powder in this case works just fine. So I'm gonna kind of pat that into the salmon, flip it over, and do the same on the other side. Let's take it to the stove. So my salmon is all ready. My pan is heated. It's got a good amount of olive oil on there, probably about 2-3 tablespoons. And I'm gonna put it topside down into the oil. And that's what you wanna hear, is a nice sizzle. You wanna use a pan big enough that'll fit all of your salmon with enough space. Otherwise, you could risk it steaming instead of getting a nice crispy sear that we're looking for. So I'm gonna let it sit like this. Don't touch it. Don't touch it for like 3 to 5 minutes. You're gonna get a nice brown coating on the bottom. We'll flip them and stick them in the oven. All right, my salmon has crisped up nicely on top. And this is real life. Sometimes that happens, but you know what? And you can kind of see that it's cooked almost fully through. So we're gonna let this finish up in the oven. The salmon turned out perfect. Make sure when you take it out of the oven, don't forget that it's hot, so use an oven mitt. I'm gonna take a nice small piece because I like the crispy edges. And I like to serve it with a salad, specifically my kale salad, because it's got some nice citrus in it to complement the citrus in here. And you can see it flakes beautifully. Perfectly juicy. Going from the stovetop to the oven, it really only takes about 3 to 5 minutes in the oven and 3 to 5 minutes on top, depending on the thickness of your piece. Oh my goodness. Nice, quick, healthy meal. Came together in literally minutes. Give this a try. Make sure you follow us and subscribe to us for more videos like this. We are in springtime, full force. Hence, all the citrus, all the herbs, all the greens,
all the deliciousness that you see here. Make sure to follow me on social media. All the information will be down in the description box below. And I hope to see you next time on The Bite. Thanks for watching.